This repurposed desktop is my Proxmox backup server system. It stores all the backups of all of my main home lab VMs, but recently it's been running into some issues and failing to complete those backups. So in this video, I want to go over my process of finding out what the problem is, troubleshooting it, and coming up with a resolution so my backups start running again. And hopefully watching me go through this process shows some interesting tools or processes that might be useful for you, or at least is entertaining. But before I dive into actually fixing the problem, let's take a look at the hardware I'm working with on hand. While PBS can be quite resource intensive with lots of servers or lots of data, for a basic home lab backup, something like this is probably likely enough, and it's going to be cheap and not very power hungry. This is an old AMD AM1 platform, a weird platform with low-end chips. It was just strange. And it has a dual-core SIMPROM on it, which is not a fast CPU by any means, and about 8 gigs of RAM. And I'm using a single hard drive to store all of my backups, in this case this 14 terabyte HMSMR drive. This is not really a suggested drive, but I had it laying around from a video, and it's been working for a few years now without problems to store all the backups on. So let's dive into the interface and try to figure out what's going on here. So now I'm on my computer and I've logged into the web interfaces for PVE and PBS on both of my systems, as well as the terminal in case I need to dive into there to get more information. So taking a look at my PVE system, the first thing I immediately notice is all these failed backup jobs. I have it set to run every hour or every other hour, it looks like, to put up my data on PBS, and they've all been reporting some sort of error. And taking a bit of a closer look at this backup job, I can see that it says backup of the number failed, and it seems to be some sort of, this one's a long one, but this input-output error OS5 keeps popping up on all of these, it looks like. So this seems like some sort of generic error, probably related to disks. Now, one thing I don't know is it my PVE server having issues reading the data, or is it my PBS server having issues writing the data or managing how it stores its backups? Because my VMs are running correctly, I'm thinking it's probably related to my PBS server. So I'm going to just take a quick look at its dashboard and some of its status to see if it reports any errors. And if PBS reports errors, it's almost certainly going to be a PBS problem. But if it doesn't report errors, it could also be a PVE problem. Taking a look at my PBS system, I can see that everything on the dashboard appears okay at first glance. I/O delay's fine, swap usage and memory usage all looks okay. So nothing immediately appears wrong here. Taking a look at my one data store called Zoned, it has about 88% of the space used, so good amount of usage, but nothing excessive and nothing to immediately raise an alarm. Taking a look at tasks and then show all tasks to see if anything's failed, I can see, that nightly garbage collection job's been failing. And it looks like it says it can't read an index file due to an I/O error. So this immediately seems to be some sort of I/O error on the system that's causing it to fail reading a file. So my immediate guess is, can I read it manually? And that tells me, is PBS doing something weird under the hood and not able to read files? Or is the file system actually not able to give it the file? So let's dive into the terminal interface and see if this can help me find out what's going on here. On my system, I know the path that it's mounted to is /mmt/zoned. I can also take a look at that in the PBS web interface by going under data center zoned summary and then see it's mounted right here. And then let's just, take a look at this data store, cd/mmt/zoned. Where all the data should be. Looks fine if I just cd into it, but if I want to cat my little backup script, that seems fine. Let's get into the PBS data. I think it was under, let's look at that exact path it was trying to read and see if I can read that exact file. So let's try reading that same catalog file. I'm just going to use the cp command to copy it into /dev/null and see if it reports any I/O errors. Nope. Okay, so that seems to be fine. One thing I also like to do is just running touch and then some random file. This should create just an empty file to see if anything's going on. And I can't make any files on here. That's not good. This should be a read-write file system. One way to possibly check that is to run the mount command, which will show everything mounted on the system. Because that's a lot of data, I'm just going to run grep and zoned, because I know /mmt/zoned is in the path. Taking a look at that will tell me the drive that's mounted on /mmt/zoned. It's also going to tell me it's an F2FS drive and that I should be mounting it read-write. This seems to be read-only right now, which is an immediate, that seems like a problem. Because a failing disk could be a possibility and easily cause these sorts of issues, I'm going to take a look under storage/disks and PBS and see what the smart data says. It looks like it's working correctly here on smart. My general rule of thumb is if smart data says a drive is bad, it's probably bad. But if it says it's good, don't just assume the drive is good, because there's been a good amount of bad drives that smart says is good that I've seen in the past. But nothing immediate here rings a bell and it says it's passed the data, so it's not certainly a dead drive, but could definitely still have issues. The one other important piece of information mount gives me is the file system used. And this is the point where the file system is doing something weird that I will say if your data is critical, probably think about data recovery services here and don't touch it anymore. Since this is a backup drive and I can just rerun these backups to fill this up again, I'm not super worried, but I would be very careful if this has critical data on it for you. But let's actually start running these F2FS tools. And I do want to continue my note that running these file system recovery tools can often make stuff worse on failing drives or weird file systems, so don't just run this if you're worried about your data. So you can run tools as part of a file system to try to figure out what the problem is, and the file system will check its own integrity. Now, typically I'd be using a file system like ext4, or XFS, BTRFS, or ZFS. But this is a zoned SMR drive which has some weird support, so the only file system I really found to work correctly is F2FS. So what I like to do is I just went to the Arch Wiki page, which has a bit of information, and it looks like fsck.f2fs and then the device, which will try checking it. So let me just try running this. Since it's just backup data, I don't mind if this happens to make it worse. It doesn't have it. So let's install those tools. F2fs-tools, I think it's typically under, but I'm not sure about Debian off the top of my head. The one great thing with PBS storing data on this drive is if I do get the file system working again, I can use PBS's verify job to make sure all the data is correct. So even if F2FS says the file system's okay and it can mount read write again, I still have another verify, which is great to know that my data can't easily be said it's correct but has bad data under the hood. It's great PBS has that nice little check data. Now that apt is finished installing this package, let's start running it again. It's a mounted device. So I'm going to need to unmount this device, which might be a bit challenging because PBS is running on it and it won't let me unmount it when stuff's running. So let me go stop all the PBS services. So the next thing is this requires it to be an unmounted device to run the F2FS check on it. The next problem is PBS is running on top of this, so I need to stop PBS so I can unmount the drive so I can run the file system check. So I'm just going to search up PBS Proxmox services and this should name all the services that's running in it. So after a bit of Googling and looking through their documentation, they have this little page on service daemons, which shows they have the little proxy, which looks like hosts the web page, and Proxmox backup, which likely runs under the hood. So let's just use system control to stop both of these, and then I can restart them or just restart the server to get those running again. Looks like it was Proxmox backup-proxy I need to stop right now. So then hopefully I can run a umount/mnt/zoned, and it'll just unmount correctly. And it looks like it did, just to verify df.h doesn't show zoned on it at all. So let's try running that fsck and see what happens. One thing I do like to run is iostat with -xm1 as the parameters, just so I can kind of see what IO is going on the drive for fun mostly. And I see it's reading about 30 megabytes per second as it's slowly running this file system check. So I'm just going to give it a minute or two to finish running its file system check job.
After nearly a day of running the F2FS file system check, I get a prompt showing that there is some issues, and it looks like actually multiple issues with the file system on this drive, and it wants me to try restoring some of the lost files into lost and found, and there's likely other tools where F2FS will try to fix the file system and get things working again. But my issue I'm thinking about is often file systems don't just fail for no reason like this. It is possible that F2FS has bugs or something, and especially since I am using this weird zoned hard drive right here, that's likely more likely than other file systems. But my inclination is that possibly there's a hardware error causing these issues with the file system that I'm going to want to check for before continuing to use this system. So I'm going to want to run a RAM check on this system to make sure there's no memory errors, as non-ECC memory can easily allow these small errors to get in there and cause file systems and other problems on it. The other thing I typically want to check for is if the hard drive has any issues. Tools like bad blocks can do this quite well to make sure it's reading and writing the data correctly. But I don't want to run that right now. First of all, this is a zone drive and most of those tools won't work. Is that most of the tools in the write mode, which gives you the most reassurance that the hard drive is actually working correctly, will overwrite all the data on the drive, effectively making it so I have to start from scratch. So I'm going to first try to fix it in F2FS because I'm actually just mostly curious if that can be fixed. And then I'm going to check the memory on the system to hopefully that's correct. And then I'm probably going to continue using it if neither of those show issues and just either assume it's some weird one-off bug. That's a lot of files that are having issues. PBS is not going to be happy about that many files getting moved to the lost and found directory. So it looks like it's finished that job right now. And I'm actually going to just go and mount this file system again just to see if it's working right now. I'm going to run sudo mount-a, and that's going to just automatically mount the drive like it normally would during boot up. Now that the file system's finished mounting, I can go into df-h. The drive looks just fine here. From what I understand the output of the F2FS tool told me is that it tried to fix the file system. I can write files to it now, but it moved some of those files to a lost and found directory due to some issues. So PBS is going to complain that the backups aren't going to be working correctly. So I'm going to have to rerun and verify those backups again. At this point, I might as well just reformat the drive and start from fresh to remove any other possible issues. And to also just have the backups already in a good starting state instead of trying to fix these kind of broken backups. Now, before I do any of that, I'm going to shut down my system and run memtest to make sure there isn't any memory issues that might be the root cause of this. Now I got my system booted up into a live Linux USB that also included memtest, and I'm just going to let this run for an hour or two to make sure that there's no memory errors, which is the root cause of all my file system troubles I've been running into, and I can just rule out memory as a problem. Memtest has finished its first pass on this system without any errors, and while errors could pop up after extended testing, I'm going to say it's unlikely that that's the case here, and just assume that this system has no memory errors and that wasn't the root cause of these file system problems. And upon rebooting my system after running memcheck, I just discovered that I have no space available on my boot partition. My first thought was maybe it was trying to run the backups onto my boot partition because my zone drive wasn't mounted, but upon running ncdu, a nice little utility for figuring out where space is used, var is pretty big, which means logs files are big, and it's mostly Proxmox backups tasks thing. So it turns out all the different tasks that I've been running and failing have been reporting themselves as logs and filling up my drive. Lovely. There's probably better ways to do this. I'm just gonna delete this folder. I don't need to keep my logs here. Probably should have a bigger partition just in case and follow the retention policies, but I just need space right now. And running df-h again, I have plenty of space, so now I can continue working on this system. And now that I have space free on the system, I'm going to try to get PBS working again. And at this point, the best option I think I have is reformatting the drive and just starting PBS to fill up the drive again. I can't see any obvious hardware faults on the system, although extended testing may reveal some of them. And file system-wise, there could be bugs, but I don't have any reason to specifically believe there are, so I'm just going to say this is just a weird one-off situation, start all over again, and hope the problem doesn't occur. I don't like these sorts of fixes, but with the amount of testing I want to do and the situation I'm in, I still kind of feel like this is the best case scenario. So what I've done is I've had my mounted drive, copied over some scripts that I liked using for backing up other partitions so I don't have to recreate those, unmounted the drive, and I'm just going to do mkfs.f2fs again on this drive. And just as a reminder, this is a zone device. That means file systems like F2FS is really the only option for me to use here. And I can't use something like ZFS, EXT4, XFS, or other common file systems. So I tried running the mkfs.f2fs command, and it seems to give this error that zoned block device feature is required. But it looks like it detected earlier host managed zoned block device. So I'm not sure. Maybe this is a hardware issue here? So what I'm going to try doing is reading the man page to the right here, and it looks like there's a dash M option that forces it into the zoned mode. Because I haven't formatted this drive in a while, I don't remember exactly what options I used when setting it up. So maybe that's it. It looks like it's starting to discard the drive, so it looks like I might have needed that dash M parameter for it to work correctly. And now that my drive is finished formatting, I'm going to edit my fstab page where this zoned drive goes in.
On FSTAB, I'm essentially telling the UUID of the drive, which is unique, so it knows which one to mount, where I want the drive to be mounted to, the file system used, and I like using this no-fail parameter with these non-boot drives. And this way, if the drive fails, I can still SSH into the system, whereas if I didn't have it, it would normally fail to boot, and I'd have to plug in a monitor like this into the system to figure out what was going on this box. So now if I run mount-a to mount all the drives automatically according to FSTAB, it should hopefully mount my zone drive again and start from scratch. If I run df-h, it looks like it's mounted correctly, showing essentially no space being used other than those 86 gigs which are likely reserved. And it looks like the drive has been mounted correctly, showing only 86 gigabytes used, which I'm guessing is reserved for some file system operations, and has the full amount of space free and ready to be used. In order to have it ready to be used by PBS, I'm just going to make a directory for PBS like I had it in my data store configuration right here under the path, and then PBS should be ready to use it. I'm just going to reboot the system so that all of my services start up again with PBS, and hopefully I can start making my backups again. And unfortunately, as I explained earlier with this fix, I don't really know if this fixed the root cause, and there might be something else happening here that I'm missing, or maybe it's just a weird one-off error. But that's annoying with a lot of problems like this, where I kind of have to fix it again and see if a pattern emerges. Otherwise, this is kind of the best fix I can think of doing right now. While more testing might reveal some root cause, I think it's not worth the additional time of testing in this case here. Weird IT issues like this are kind of annoying, and I run them into a lot with probably suboptimal solutions. But the system seems to be running right now, and if I run df-h, I can see that my zone drive is mounted. So let's switch into PBS and see if it starts working correctly now. And looking at PBS, it looks very unhappy and says some issue about the data store and can't get any information, likely because when I reformatted the drive, I removed all the data store information at once. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna remove the data store, and then I'm going to re-add it. And then this is essentially gonna recreate all the data store information again and hopefully have it work. And it looks like the web page needs a second to add it. So I'm just gonna put that same name in so then I can keep all my backup jobs the same. I then just put that same path I used earlier, and hopefully it will just start running again. And after a second of creating the chunk store, it looks like my repository is good right now. It sees the correct amount of free space on the system, so it's using the right drive. And if I switch over to my Proxmox virtualization system and start running that backup job right now, hopefully it'll start copying backups over the network. And it looks like it's copying files over the network at my expected speed for my slow old PBS system, so the backups are starting again. And unfortunately, as I mentioned earlier with this fix, I don't really know if this is a fix, so I'm just gonna have to give this system a bit of time and hope it doesn't fail again. Let me know if you've had fixes or weird issues of file systems like F2FS like this in the past and how your fixes have gone for you. Hopefully this was a fun watch me troubleshoot my computers video, and let me know if you want to see more videos like this in the future. Thanks for watching.